Welcome. We're here along for the Bloomfield Christmas Tournament Championship. We've got the top seed, Kennett Indians, taking on the sixth seed, Holcomb Hornets. I'm Tyler Widener along with Ed Dargis bringing you this championship game. And Ed, this is the fourth time that Kennett will be going for the Christmas Tournament title. That's big for the Kennett Indians, but probably even bigger, the Holcomb Hornets in the championship game. They were in the tournament for the first time 2 years ago, and 2 years later they find themselves in the tournament championship.
Yes, and that's truly exciting. You know, you got to tip your hat to Coach McBroom. He's done a wonderful job with the program there. It helps when you got a Jamie Massey in the lineup, obviously. Jamie's having an outstanding tournament as well. But his team, they've been playing within themselves. Guard play with Reeves and Davis here. And also Chase Davis doing a good job protecting the ball, getting the ball inside to Davies. But probably one that – The hidden weapon of the Holcomb Hornets is Glover, Michael Glover. You know, so many times the double team has stepped down on Massey. Massey picks it right up, and Glover's converting at a very high percentage when he's the open guy. And so Coach Bond's got to have picked up on that after 3 days of watching the Holcomb Hornets be successful. We'll see how much activity, as he's got a very active defense and even more active offense.
I think we're going to see early on how this game is going to go. If Holcomb can handle the ball pressure of Kennett, they can get into the half court, get into their sets, and execute in the half court, they're going to be successful. But if they're going to have a hard time taking control of the ball, if they're going to be turning the ball over due to Kennett's pressure, it's going to be a long night for the Hornets. But that's what we'll have to look at early on to see how this game is going to develop, because I think that's going to be the key, whether Holcomb can handle the ball pressure of Kennett.
I agree. Starting for the Holcomb Hornets.
Starting for Holcomb, guard, 5'10". Number one,
Chase Davis, the 5'10" senior.
And guard for Holcomb, 6'5",
number 23, Ryan Reeves, 6' junior.
And forward.
Number 30, James Vance, 6'3", senior.
And center, 6'7", number 32.
Number 32, Jamie Massey, the 6'7", senior. And number 33, Michael Glover, the 6'3", senior. And starting for the Indians, number one, Montavious Drake, 5'11", junior. Number 14, Colin Smith, 6'2", senior. Number 20, 6'4", junior, Kevontae Mitchell. Number 22, 6'1", sophomore, Harold Whedon. And number 32, Antonio Primer, the 6'4" senior. I think, too, it's going to be important early for Kennett, though, to get into some scoring rhythm. They've had some trouble this year off to slow starts, let some ball teams that should not have been in ball games with them be in ball games with them. And Massey has that ability. They like to go to the hole. He's a big obstacle getting around and getting the ball in the cylinder, and that could play some effect also and could allow Holcomb that if Kennett's not scoring, they're not getting into that full court press, and that could go in Hawkins' favor as well. We'll have Primer jumping against Massey. Kennett controls the tip. Wheaton to set the offense. Over to Drake. Drake to Mitchell. Back to Wheaton. Primer.
Ball taken away by Davis.
So Davis having trouble with the ball himself. Gets it over to Glover for three. Won't go. Long rebound. Out of bounds off the Hornets. So it'll go with the Indians. Learned during the first game, some people sitting in the crowd talking about Devontae Mitchell and how good of a basketball player he is. Come to find out he's even better, or maybe in some minds, even better baseball player.
Yeah, I haven't.
And they're talking about him. You know, he's only a junior, but coming out his senior year is a high probability he may be drafted straight out of high school.
I haven't seen him play baseball, but I've read about him and seen some of his stats. Pretty impressive. So, I mean, he's an all-around athlete, and he's going to be successful in anything he does.
Drake spins, jump, in and out, won't go. Rebound Massey.
And the foul's going to be on Whedon.
Inbound to Reeves. Think I heard earlier today a red Reeves drives, tries to go up and under, but won't make it. We got a foul on the play. Number 22, Whedon, his second. So in a minute into the ball game, Whedon's going to take an early seat. It's Reeves to shoot two.
Reeves has got to step up for the Hornets tonight. He's been playing very well throughout the tournament. He's just got to stay consistent, be aggressive tonight.
And number 10, Akeem Nelson, the freshman, comes in for Whedon. Reeves connects on both. Reeves struggled a bit from the charity stripe Saturday night. Not to the detriment of the Hornets, obviously, as they were victorious. Mitchell steps back.
Primer on the drive is taken away by Massey.
Massey over to Davis. Davis spins. Gets it to Glover. Reeves to Vance. I believe today might be Vance's birthday, if I heard correctly earlier. And under back door, Davis cannot connect. Out of bounds off Mitchell.
Yeah, we got an email earlier from James Vance's mother, Mary Vance, I believe, wishing him a happy birthday to go Hornets.
Massey up top, up and over. There you go.
And that's Holcomb's game. Get it to Massey on the block. He's automatic in between those blocks.
Automatic, but not quite perfect.
Right.
Mitchell drives, spins. Met Glover in the paint. Loses the handle on the ball back to the Hornets.
Nice look.
Vance underneath.
Nice start for the Holcomb Hornets. Quick timeout by the Kennett Indians. The Holcomb Hornets up by six early on. We'll be right back.
For more than 75 years, the law firm of Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh & Shear, LLP, has served the legal needs of Southeast Missouri. Located at 308 First Street in Kennett, Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh & Shear, LLP is a full-service law firm providing representation in a wide range of areas, such as personal injury, workers' compensation, family law, criminal law, probate, business, and estate planning. For all your legal needs, call Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh & Shear, LLP at 573-888-4664.
And we're back. A hot start by the Holcomb Hornets, but Tyler doing exactly what the Hornets doing exactly what you said they needed to on the defensive end. They're packing it down into the paint. Kennett is not going to get that slash and moving drive. They're going to have to hit some jump shots to spread that zone out a little bit.
That's what it's looking like early on. Holcomb's not going to give up the paint easily. They're going to sag back once they're on the drive.
Primer gets loose there. Won't get the roll. Massey polices up the rebound. Steal by Mitchell. Back to Primer. Nice dish to Drake. No foul on the call.
Nice defense by the Hornets.
Davis. Nelson with the rebound. He pushes it up the court. Floater won't go. Drake with the rebound.
A And we're taking your tweets and your emails, so send them on to us, sports@cmosportszone.com, the email, and tweet us at cmosportszone. We're having a little troubles with the reception here, but send them on to us.
Nelson short. Vance drives the baseline, spins, gets it to Massey. Like you said, automatic between the blocks. 8-0 start for the Hornets.
Kennett's going to have to apply a lot of ball pressure out front to make it difficult to get it down to Massey. That's probably the only way you can really prevent him from getting the ball is apply the pressure out front on the guards.
Mitchell goes around, gets the bucket.
Nelson almost gets a steal there under the basket, but he's out of bounds. It'll stay with the Hornets.
Vance takes a seat as number five. Tyler Lewis comes in for the Hornets. And number two, Cameron Harper, in for the Indians.
Reeves on the drive, spins, goes up in the paint, no good.
Lewis with the putback, won't go. Massey tip, won't go. Rebound Nelson.
And strong pass from Nelson. He's got an arm on him, and they found out there in the first row.
Yeah. Coach Botch found out as well.
Inbound to Glover.
Glover working against the defense. Nice dribble. Nice. Over to Reeves.
Deep three for Reeves.
The three. Count it.
Big shot for Ryan Reeves. He's had a great tournament shooting the ball. He's going to definitely look for that shot tonight, and the Hornets need him to. Step
Mitchell
back
for three, won't go off the glass. Nelson the rebound. Step back and reset the offense. Primer for three, it won't go. Rebound Davis.
And a push foul underneath.
Foul will be on Smith, his first. 13th foul against the Indians. One team foul against the Hornets, against Reeves.
And we'll get to a tweet here real quick from Michelle Harrelson. Shout out to Coach Jim Vaughn and Kennett Indians for mom and dad watching in South Carolina. Four in a row. Appreciate the tweet.
Reeves for three. Won't go. Mitchell the rebound. Mitchell called for the charge.
Holcomb's doing a nice job closing off that paint.
One thing for Coach Vaughn, though, this up-tempo pace, he is not concerned with it. They play 9 or 10 deep. Holcomb, not quite as deep. I haven't watched them much this season, just this tournament. And having the day off yesterday will help those legs. But this kind of pace, I don't know if this is what Coach McBroom wants for the four full quarters. Reeves steps in, shot. It's got to be off. Rebound Nelson for Kennett. Pushes it up to Drake. Drake drives, won't go. Smith with the follow. Lewis working against Drake. Edgington also in the ball game for the Indians. Coach Vaughn's not going to mind seeing Massey out there by the three-point line.
Holcomb's doing a nice job handling the pressure early on.
Number 10, Cameron Clark in for the Hornets there. Lewis to Clark. How many times are you going to be able to say that tonight?
All right.
Over to Glover. Down low to Massey. Steps, shot. Won't go this time. Smith, nice rebound.
Pretty good defense there by Kennett. Colin Smith just holding his ground, making it difficult as possible for Massey.
Edgington, call for the walk. .202 to go here in the first, 7-point lead still for the Hornets.
Reeves being hassled, knocked out of bounds by Drake. I'll tell you, this is some tough Kennett ball pressure on these Holcomb guards. And I tell you, that's one thing that you mentioned. Holcomb's going to have to really dig deep because they're going to get that pressure all game. Come the late third and fourth quarters, they're going to really be feeling it.
Not just physically, but mentally.
Ball goes to
Massey up at the high block, or high post, excuse me. Clark down to Lewis.
Oh, nice dump pass just to let it out of reach. And we have a tweet from Devin Sloan. Let's go, Holcomb. Keep those tweets and emails coming. At SEMO Sports Zone for the tweets. Sports at SEMOSportsZone.com for the emails.
Primer back in for Kennett. Vance in for Glover for the Hornets. Drake to Nelson. To Mitchell. Mitchell working Lewis. Goes around him. Faces Massey and wins this battle. Reeves drives, loses the handle. Going to be off the foot to stop the fast break from Kennett.
Fortunate bounce for Holcomb there. Looked like Kennett was going to come away with a steal and have numbers in the open court.
Clark. Stripped from behind. Smith. That time ball, Drake. Nice play there by Clark, you know, but back forth, Drake slapped the ball, went off Massey, and Kennett winds up with the ball with a minute to go here in the first and a five-point deficit. Mitchell to Drake. Up top to Nelson.
Tough shot by Nelson. Picked up by Primer. Runs out of space, but he's actually pushed.
Yeah.
Looks like
foul
it's on
30.
James Vance.
Vance.
42 seconds remaining in this first quarter.
Mitchell. Drake from the baseline. 30 seconds to go. Again, Kennett applying the pressure. Lewis, Primer with the steal. Drake, pull-up jumper, won't go. Primer rebound and cut.
Cuts the lead to one, now down to 15 seconds.
Davis, high off the
nice
board.
Drive.
Way to use that board, young Mr. Davis.
Tough shot, now with 5 seconds.
Primer. Up under, too late. Won't go. So after one, Hornets on top, 13-10. We'll take a break and we'll be back.
Stop by and visit the new Las Fisas restaurant on Business 25 in Malden. They've expanded to provide you with the most authentic Mexican experience. Try their daily lunch specials. You won't beat these prices. $4.99 fajita special on Tuesday. $2.99 Speedy Gonzalez on Wednesday. And $4.99 chimichanga special on Friday. Dine in or carry out at Las Brisas, authentic Mexican restaurant in Malden.
I want to stay connected to you. I like the way you do what you do. All right, okay, you're fine.
Call Audubel Hearing Center at 1-800-499-8786 or visit one of our locations in Dexter and Poplar Bluff, Missouri today.
Dan, we're back. There you see some of the Kennett faithful, Tanya Smith, Michelle Lane, Matt and Beth Shetley there watching. Tanya, mother of Colin Smith, playing basketball. And I was here the first night. We got her on camera there. Also that first morning, I guess I should say. Let her know you saw her on TV. Shoot her a text here real quick. There's a steal by Primer. He goes up and bucket.
Now we're seeing
the lead to one again. Smith with the save to Primer. Back up to Mitchell. This time Glover watching and Massey's there off the glass for his third bucket. 6 points for Massey now on the night.
And we're seeing a touch violation after the basket. That's just a warning. So if it happens again, be a technical foul, but we'll get back to action here. But we're starting to see Kennett's pressure starting to dial up. Holcomb having a few turnovers here, but they're fortunate to get that turnover right back and get an easy two with Massey. But that's still an element to this game that's going to be important for both teams.
Primer just missed the bucket right after the clock ended in the first. Came right back on the set here to start the second quarter. So he's excited about this game. He's into it. Violation there. Ball turned over to the Hornets. I believe the call was 3 seconds, but I didn't see it. Vance, or excuse me, Reeves working against Mitchell.
And ball
steal by Primer off Vance. He's up front to Nelson. Count it.
A nice finish by Nelson, and another forced turnover. Kennett's starting to play their game now.
Here comes Mitchell. Davis loses the handle. Pulled in by Smith. Drake pushing the ball up the court. Over to Nelson. Gets the roll. And like that, Kennett now has the lead. And with that, Holcomb calls timeout. We'll take a break, and we'll be back.
At Glenn St. and Kennett, we have a lot full of inventory and the best rebates of the year. I'm Danny Ford, owner of Glenn St. We just want the opportunity to talk to you about your next car or truck. The rebates are the best of the year, and interest rates the lowest to work with. It's a great time to buy, and our people are excited to help you make the right choice. We realize you have a lot of dealers to choose from, but I can assure you, no one appreciates your business like we do. Glenn St. and Kennett, and God bless our troops.
And Ed, I talked to Coach McBroom before the game, and he wanted to make sure that we sent a shout out to a couple of friends of his that had a new baby boy this morning. That's Danny and Alicia Seal. They had a baby boy named Hudson. They're watching the game from the hospital room on YHC TV. So we appreciate Seth bringing that to us, and hope everyone's doing fine.
Well, congratulations to the Seals. Vance. To give the Hornets the lead again. Massey with the rebound. Glover, excuse me, Reeves working against Harper. Harper in for the Indians, call for the foul. Cameron Harper, 5'11 senior. Reeves working against Mitchell. Picked by Mitchell, he's out front. Vance, foul, and a roll. So Mitchell gets the bucket. He'll be on the line to shoot the traditional, or the attempt at the traditional three. Vance picks up his second foul here. Converts. 2-point largest lead for Kennett. There's another steal. As you said, Tyler, the pressure starting to mount. Primer, Mitchell there to clean it up. Mitchell now 5 points in the quarter, 9 for the ball game. Lewis. Glover. Massey at the high post. Double team. Puts the ball on court. Contested by Smith and Primer. No foul, but policed up by Lewis. Glover back door. Nice.
Nice finish by Glover.
Mitchell loses the handle. Harper for three. Glover with the rebound.
Now Davis is on the break. It's a boot. Nice run out by the Hornets.
Drake splits the defense. Won't go. Antonio Primer rebound. Won't go. Massey's going to be called over the back. That'll be Massey's first.
And we mentioned this already, Ed, that Hornet's going to have no pressure, but for Massey's sake, he's having to run back, and if they turn it over, he's having to come back. He'll run three quarters of the court just to come back and play defense, so they've got to let him get some, you know, good possessions down the court.
Mitchell, three won't go. Rebound, Edgerton. Saved by Reeves, the primer, though. He gets it out to Drake. Drake shot, won't go. Primer showing a lot of quickness for the big guy. Steal by Nelson.
Looked like Glover had his feet taken out from under
Mitchell
him.
Mitchell setting the offense.
Off the foot
Mitchell
of Massey.
Up. Yep. Off the foot of Massey, there
yep.
you go. Well, you got one size 21 or whatever he wears. Can't blame Massey.
Right.
Edgerton looks for three. Won't go, a little long. Reeves to Glover. Down low to Massey underneath. Can't stop that. And with that, Holcomb takes the lead back. Mitchell won't go. Foul on Edgerton. His first. 16 fouls now against Kennett Indians. Reeves to Davis. Davis. Massey guarded by Primer. Out to Glover. Lewis. Reeves. Massey there at the high post. Sees the floor so well. Lewis to shoot the three. Won't go. Rebound Davis. Excuse me. Drake. Primer. Shoot the three. Count it. 7 points now from Antonio Primer. Official timeout as Drake's allowed off the court. And that gives the Indians a 1 point lead.
Can it stay in the full court pressure?
Get pass over to Davis. Lewis, Reeves. Back out to Glover from the baseline. Count it. Good looking shot there by Michael Glover.
Nice shot by Glover. Even better assist by Reeves.
Primer. Lost the handle. Reeves. Fouled. I think the foul's going to go against number 10, Nelson. It does. And that'll put Reeves on the line shooting two. Also puts Holcomb in the bonus. Edgerton now back to Mitchell. Edgerton looks at three. Count it.
Nice shot there by Edgerton.
Massey, ooh. Nice looking move there.
Tough shot by Massey.
That gives him 6 1/4 and 10 for the ball game. Mitchell, the long three, resulting in a long rebound. Davis down to Glover, back out top to Reeves. Pull it out and set the offense. Lewis to Massey, guarded by Edgerton. Davis looking to split the defense.
Oh, nice move.
Nice move by Davis, the 5'10 senior. Not afraid to take it down low.
Seeing the defense kind of shade the Massey a little bit, so it opened up Davis with an opportunity with that drive.
And a great head fake got Edgington off his feet. Edgington for three. Won't get the bounce. Davis with the rebound. Under a minute to go, Holcomb with the two-point lead.
Oh.
Almost a steal by Primer.
A couple dangerous passes by Holcomb. And a third one.
Harper. Mitchell splits, drives, and the bounce.
Tied this game up. We've got 30 seconds left in this first half.
Mitchell now in double digits with 11. seconds to go here in the half. Lewis to Reeves to Davis. Steal by Primer. Mitchell's out front. And that's what you do when you're way out front. So with that, Kennett, the last 4 points in the ballgame, and at the half, to go into the half, leading by two. We're going to take a break, and we'll be back.
These days, we're bombarded with insurance ads and websites. But can they really save you money? Trammell & Son Insurance represents over 70 years. Family-owned for four generations, all familiar with the particular needs of CMO farmers. And offering convenience, low rates, and fast, friendly, local service. Call Trammell & Son Insurance for an insurance assessment. Whether it's farm, home, or commercial, we can tell you what's best for your situation so you won't be over or underinsured. Put our experience to work for you. Trammell & Sun Insurance.
Thank you.
Accepting the latest in diagnostic technology, designer frames and contact lenses. Accepting Medicaid, and most insurances. MHJ Insurance Agency, serving the Heartland since 1935. Give them a call or stop by for a free quote on all of your insurance needs. As an independent agent, they have many options for you when shopping for insurance. Call today, 624-6246. Skeeter Kell Sporting Goods in Sykeston, your local source for all your sports supplies, apparel, and screen printing. Contact Lloyd Rice for team or special orders at 471-5668. The Quality Center Furniture and Appliance Store in Malden. They've got Maytag and Whirlpool appliances, large variety of furniture, and LG and Hitachi HD TVs. Also an AT&T authorized retailer. The Quality Center at 122 South Madison. This game brought to you by SEMO Vision Care in Malden.
If you have the audacity to believe a financial advisor should talk with you, not at you.
If you have the nerve to believe meeting eye to eye helps you see eye to eye.
If you believe access to your financial advisor should be a right, not a privilege.
Join the nearly 7 million investors who think like you do. FaceTime and ThinkTime make a difference.
Join us.
Join us. Join us.
At Edward Jones, it's how we make sense of investing.
Let's talk about next year. This is the time of year to reflect on last season's crop and make decisions for next season. What mix of crops should you plant? Should you buy new equipment this year or get by another year with what you have? We'd like to help you make the financial side of your planning a little easier. Our ag department knows agriculture, and they're local.
Stop by and see us
at First Midwest Bank.
When was the last time you've been to Wilcoxon's Homeplace Furniture and Appliance?
Not sure.
Well, then you have been missing out on all kinds of incredible furniture.
Really?
Yes. They have furniture for every room in your home, in styles you want, and at prices you can afford.
Are you talking about Wilcoxon Homeplace Furniture and Appliance on the South Bypass in Kennett?
Take a few minutes and make the drive to Wilcoxon's Homeplace Furniture and Appliance and rediscover quality furniture for all rooms of your home.
With an interactive home security system from New Wave, your family comes home to peace of mind. Now we bring you the future of home security. Arm and disarm your system remotely from your office computer or iPhone. Even look in on family or pets with live video from inside your home. In an emergency, our 24/7 alarm monitoring responds with the help you need. Peace of mind, wherever you are. Now available from New Wave Communications.
And we're here at halftime from Bloomfield. 31-29 advantage for the Kennett Indians. And Ed, we saw a very competitive first half. Holcomb was able to get execute in the half court when they weren't turning the ball over, but that's what's really hurt them. They turned the ball over a few times there, as we saw at the last of the first half. Kevontae Mitchell getting a breakaway dunk. And that's what we talked about going into this game. Can Holcomb handle the ball pressure from the Kennett Indians? And they have to some extent, but they have turned it over a few times. And that's what's keeping Kennett in this game with a two-point lead right now, is being able to force turnovers.
You bet. Holcomb got out to a phenomenal start. I believe the first 8 points of the ball game. Had the court spread, handled the pressure very well, fresh legs came out, and then got the ball to Massey, but also Glover executed as well when he had the open shot. Midway through the second quarter, the pressure starts to mount just a little bit. Fatigue starts to set in just a little bit again. Holcomb not as deep as Kennett. Those legs got a little tired. Those shots didn't fall, but the pressure kept with Kennett, resulting in four turnovers. And there you saw, like you said, Kevontae Mitchell with the slam dunk to end the half. And so, but Coach Vaughn, quick timeout. You know, they're a minute and a half into the ball game, made the adjustments and let the players know here's where they're beating us. The Kennett players responded correctly to the coaches coaching, and got on a little run themselves. Now we got an exciting ball game setting up for the second half.
Sure do, and we talked about it going in, whether Holcomb can handle the pressure in probably the late third and fourth quarters, and guards are going to start losing their legs with that so much pressure out front by the Indians. The Indians just throwing guys in and out. They're going to be able to throw more guys at you, stay fresher. You know, the guards out front like Lewis, Reeves, and Davis, are they going to be able to hold up in the fourth quarter? taking control of the ball, getting into the half court, letting Massey and Glover and those guys get their looks and into the half court set. We'll see if that happens, but it's going to be a very competitive second half that we're going to look forward to here in Bloomfield.
You bet. Real quick in the first half scoring for the Holcomb Hornets, they were led by Jamie Massey, 10 points, 6 points to Chase Davis, 5 points to Ryan Rees, and then 4 points each to James Vance and Michael Glover. For the Kennett Indians, 13 points to Cavante Mitchell, 7 to Antonio Primer, 4 points for Akeem Nelson, 3 points Jay Edgington, 2 points Ontavious Drake, as well as Colin Smith. So a little more diverse, but Cavante Mitchell being the workhorse for the Kennett Indians in the first half.
There's old Terry McVay on hand for tonight's game. He's usually here in the booth with us and usually doing this championship game, but he went under heart surgery, I think a little over a month ago, and he's recovering, so it's good to have him here in the Bloomfield Gymnasium.
You bet. He's been following the games on YHC, sent us a couple of tweets and emails. So, but like you said, it's best to see him out and about, and he said he's really enjoying the tournament, so glad to hear that.
Here we go, getting underway with your second half. Possession will go to the Indians.
Looks like a starting five for Kennett. Harper in for Drake here the second half, and we'll see how long this lasts, but Mitchell over to Harper, down to Smith, back to Mitchell, loses the handle, kicks it back out wisely to Harper. Holcomb's out on the perimeter a little bit more than they started out, 3-2 zone, but they collapsed into that paint so well and so tight, not allowing any penetration there from the Indians. Wheaton for three, won't go, long rebound Massey. Reeves working against Harper.
Looking for that backdoor cut, nobody there. Turns it over to the Indians.
Harper bring the ball down for the Indians. The Indians content to play it a little slower here, getting started. See Drake standing on the side. He tweaked his ankle a little bit. He may still be nursing that just a bit, getting it warmed up. Mitchell to give and go to Primer. Up over Massey, won't go. Rebound Vance. See, shuttles it out to Davis. Say it's off Wheaton. Staying with the Hornets. Davis working against Weavis. Wheaton, excuse me.
There's the back door.
There's the back door Glover. He does that well.
I think they had that drawn up last time, but executed it this time down.
And with that, we got a tie ball game. Primer, the turnaround won't go. Massey out, rebound Smith. Reeves pushes it to Vance. Found himself a little far into the goal, but rebound can't be handled by the Indians. Out of bounds, back to the Hornets. Inbound to Massey, up top to Davis. Glover in the paint, loses his footing. Mitchell with the steal. Mitchell splits the defense. Does not get the roll, but he gets the foul.
Nice aggressiveness there by Mitchell. He's been doing that all game. If he gets the open court, he's going to try to take it all the way to the hoop. And Holcomb's really got to get back on defense. They had a few of them try to reach in to stop him, but you're better off just to hightail it down to the end of the court, try to keep him from the paint.
Reeves called for his third. In around and got the roll. Reeves comes out, Lewis back in. And a second. Puts Mitchell at 15 for the ball game. A 2-point lead for the Kennett Indians.
Lewis
Mitchell went for the steal. Good ball handling there by Lewis. Davis shot, count it.
Nice set there by Holcomb, being patient, getting Davis around that screen.
Mitchell spins, dumps it to Primer. to Harper.
And while we got a break in the action, we got a few tweets here. Got one from Whitney. I think it's Weisinger. Go Nelson and Crothers. Nelson on the floor, but Crothers yet to be on the court for the Indians this year, I believe.
Got both one. Of those guys are freshmen for the Indians. He yep. made the game Saturday night, Crothers deal, toward the very end there. But
got one from Luke Hellebush. Let's go Hornets. Hashtag Hornet Nation.
Got the floor cleaned up. Primer for three. Won't go. Rebound Smith. Back up block. Call for the foul. Foul going to be on Massey, his second. Smith to shoot two. Weeden to take a seat. Drake checks in. Smith good on both. Davis pushing the Hornets down the court, or up the court, says I got it. Glover, Massey, guarded by Smith. Reeves, guarded by Harper. Lewis, short, rebound Primer. Harper. Drake, Primer. Primer guarded by Glover, goes up. Won't go, rebound Massey and Glover. Glover with credit. Pass to Lewis. Finds Davis in the corner. Nice pass taken away by Kennett. Primer out front. And the layup. Reeves working against Harper. And Mitchell. And the steal, but Harper going to be called for the foul. Be Cameron's second. Cameron Clark kicked in there for the Hornets. Number 10. Reeves gets through the defense, policed up by Massey. Nice play by Massey. Heads up play. Nelson. Shot, won't go, rebound, glass, good no foul by Massey. Nelson out to Clark, steps in, Grady.
Nice shot there, that's
Cameron's
a tough shot.
First bucket. Nelson being sized up by Clark, or excuse me, Drake. Down low to Smith, goes up, no foul. Primer with the rebound. No shot. Sandy Walt, the turnover Indian, back to the Hornets. Mitchell slips. Glover down low to Massey. Nice footwork there by Massey. Big guy ties the ball game. Primer.
I think foul the foul's going Glover. He'll be on Glover on the way to the basket.
Michael's first foul. 13th foul this half against the Indians, or the Hornets. Primer will shoot two. Nelson checks in for Smith. Little strong. Rebound Wheaton, but couldn't handle it.
First opportunity there by Kennett.
Lewis. Massey all alone. Contested by Nelson, but Nelson with the foul. King's second foul. Second team foul against the Indians this half, and Massey is shooting two. Massey gives the Hornets the lead. Mitchell. Coach Vaughn helping his offense there.
Reach in foul, looks like on, is that Lewis?
I think it's Clark, his first.
Clark.
Nelson for three, short. Mitchell with the rebound, up. He's fouled. I think that's gonna go against Glover, which will be his second.
Mitchell fought hard for that rebound. There among Glover and Massey.
Mitchell a little strong. Good on the second.
Oh, off the hands of Harper, but he regains it.
Mitchell weaves through, followed by Lewis.
He got caught with the technical there.
Technical for hanging on the rim. I know he thought he had somebody underneath him, but
well,
still going to be the technical.
He went up and initially tried to dunk it back, but anytime you hang on the rim and then try to attempt to grab it, when you're on the rim, it's automatic there. So a great effort by Nelson. It's just instincts to try to go after it.
Glover shoot.
Still pretty amazing as a freshman going up and trying to dunk that shot back. Glover converts.
To give the Hornets a three-point lead.
That's a potentially a, you know, a six-point swing here. If Hawkins come away with 4 points on this possession, it could have been easily 2 points on the other side for Kennett.
Ball inbounded to Reeves. Working against Harper. Steal by Drake. Foul by Davis. be his first. 16 fouls now against the Hornets. Cuts it to a two-point lead. And the roll. 2 minutes to go here in the third. One-point lead for the Hornets. Reeves working against Harper.
And 5 seconds.
Good defense there by Montavious Drake, preventing Reeves from making an offensive move toward the goal. Mitchell squares up, short, rebound, Primer. Primer now with 11 in the ball game.
And a reaching foul on Wheaton. On that previous play there, Ed, Massey went out to check the shot on Mitchell. Actually, got a good hand in his face. It was a little short, but you know, anytime that Massey's out checking a shot, that leaves out open a void for a rebound opportunity for the Hornets, and Primer snuck in there and got an easy putback.
Wheaton called for his third foul. Clark to Reeves. Down to Massey. Nice give and go there. Indians saw it coming, but just not enough height to get it done. Primer counters. Primer, 6 points this quarter. Massey leading all scorers with 18. Primer with the steal. Up to Smith. Contest by Massey, but goes straight up. Smith now 4 points this quarter. A 3-point lead for the Indians with under a minute to go here in the third. Massey with the rebound.
Basket and the foul.
Count it. Foul on Primer, his first. Opportunity to tie the ball game.
I mean, just when you think Kennett's going to have an opportunity to break this thing open, they get a 3-point opportunity here.
And good. Mitchell, Primer, up, won't go, short, rebound Massey, 20 seconds. Reeves picks up his dribble. Helps have oh, nice look by Massey. Glover goes up and he's fouled. Foul's gonna be on Tavies Drake. His first 16 fouls now for both teams. Good on both. Holcomb comes out with the pressure this time. Primer to Mitchell, shoots, won't go. And after three, Holcomb Hornets on top, 50-48. We'll take a break and we'll be back.
For more than 75 years, the law firm of Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, has served the legal needs of Southeast Missouri. Located at 308 First Street in Kennett, Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, is a full-service law firm providing representation in a wide range of areas, such as personal injury, workers' compensation, family law, criminal law, probate, business, and estate planning. For all your legal needs, call Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, at 573-888-4664.
Stop by and visit the new Las Brisas restaurant on Business 25 in Malden. They've expanded to provide you with the most authentic Mexican experience. Try their daily lunch specials. You won't beat these prices. $4.99 fajita special on Tuesday, $2.99 Speedy Gonzalez on Wednesday, and $4.99 chimichanga special on Friday. Dine in or carry out at Las Brisas, authentic Mexican restaurant in Malden.
Great third quarter, Ed. We're geared up for an even better fourth quarter. Hawkins been able to maintain the pressure of Kennett. They've turned it over a few times, but Kennett not executing in the half court as well as they probably should. They're not getting as good of looks as they were in the first half.
Yes, and what we talk about the fatigue on the Hornets, but Devontae Taylor went down in the second game for the Kennett Indians and has not been back in the tournament since. He's the substitute for Antonio Primer primarily. So Primer, we might want to watch him this fourth quarter also, as his legs are on the court a lot longer tonight than they have been the other three games. But there he is with a steal. Gets it out front to Drake. Pull it, jumper good. Drake now 6 points in the ball game. Glover, shot, won't go, rebound Primer. Out front to Mitchell. Foul by Davis. Be Davis' second. Mitchell will go to the line to shoot two. Mitchell 4 of 5 from the line so far tonight.
Mitchell's been a little out of rhythm here in the second half. He's missed a few free throws and hasn't gotten into an offensive rhythm. He's going to certainly look to here in the fourth.
Good on the second. Defense by Primer. We got timeout Hawkins with 7:09 to go in the ball game. We'll take a break and we'll be back.
I want to stay connected to you. I like the way you do what you do. All right. Okay. You're fine. Ah. Hey.
Call Audubel Hearing Center at 1-800-499-8786 or visit one of our locations in Dexter and Poplar Bluff, Missouri today.
Let me get a few of these. Hey, we got a few tweets to read here. We got one from Jerry Jones. Says, Kennett will prevail in the end. Too athletic for the Hornets. John and Leon McAnally, we'll see. We knew that coming in. They're going to be more athletic, but the Hawkins Hornets hanging tough right
still
now.
Still got to execute.
Yep, we'll see how it all plays out. Also, Michelle Harrelson asking how many points that Jamie Massey's got. He's had a good night.
21.
21 points for Massey.
Inbound play to Clark. Gets it to Massey, loses the handle, back up. Make it 23 points for the big guy. And a 1-point lead for the Hornets. You got to think Hawkins' game plan from here on out is just going to hang on the ball and try to get it down low to Massey. As Clark's going to be called for his second foul.
Good play there by Mitchell. Stay aggressive towards the paint. Pick up the foul. Get yourself to the line. Low-scoring game like this, getting to the free throw line and having a chance to convert is very important.
Earns the right for a second. Connects. There's the pressure defense from Kennett.
Now we're seeing Glover handle the ball quite a bit for Holcomb. I don't know if that's a design.
Now to Massey again up and over Smith. Massey 25 points in the ball game. Primer.
Nice
block by Massey. Out of bounds off Reeves, I believe.
That's what makes it so tough with Massey there in the paint. He doesn't pick up fouls easily. He stays out of foul trouble, stays disciplined with his spacing.
Nelson to Drake. Mitchell steps back to Drake. Mitchell looks for the baseline, finds it. Up and under, won't go, followed by Primer. Primer with 15 in the ball game. Davis, double team, steal by Mitchell, draped out front, and the layup, won't go. Followed by Nelson, won't go, and back.
Oh, man.
Nelson and Mitchell fought over the business. Same team, disrupting the rebound, and a perfect opportunity there for the Indians. 3-on-none, coming away with nothing. Reeves drives. Nice drive by Reeves.
Nice drive by Reeves. Missed opportunity by Kennett that previous series.
Smith.
Oh, nice block. Almost saved by Holcomb, but.
Out of bounds off Clark. That was Reeves' first bucket since the first quarter. Ryan Reeves now has 7 in the ballgame. Smith inbounds. Nelson will look for 3, short. Primer with the rebound, up and good. Primer now is 17 in the ball game. Davis working against Nelson, shoots the 3.
Oh,
Davis
nice shot.
Now with 11 in the ball game. Massey. Steps out this time, call for the foul.
Mitchell staying aggressive, getting himself to the line.
Hornets now have 9 team fouls. In and out, won't get the bounce. Rebound Glover.
Long pass to Davis.
Count it. 4-point lead. Mitchell will shoot 3. Won't go. The 4 Holcomb Hornets there for the rebound. The biggest being Massey. So Kennett Strider is starting to show us few signs of impatience. Nice pass to Glover up underneath and gets the roll. Glover 12 points in the ball game.
Yeah, Kennett's not being able to pressure the ball. They're getting some good opportunities. What we saw in the first half, they're not doing here in the fourth.
Bass called, going to be called with a foul, I think. That'll be his 4th.
Looks like some of all the guys on the court right now are going to be gassed, but it seems like especially the guards out front for both teams really sucking wind right now. But Kennett, especially, they need to pick up the defense and force Holcomb to do more from the perimeter.
Smith get a break. Primer comes in. Harper comes in. Nelson or Mitchell will get a break as well. Second won't go. Primer will be called over the back.
Massey's going to go to the line to shoot a 1-on-1.
Team foul number 7. So that'll put Massey at the line, shooting a 1-on-1. count it. Which little long, rebound Glover. Out of bounds off Nelson, so he'll stay with the Hornets. Massey, 25 points on the, for the evening. 4 minutes to go here in the ballgame.
Long pass.
Stolen on the inbound by Whedon. He pushes the ball up the court, down the court, excuse me. Nelson, floater counted.
Drake being pretty physical, but he picks up the foul.
That'll be on Tavy's second. And it will put Chase Davis at the line, shooting the front end of a 1-on-1. Good. Davis extends lead back to 6. Wheaton for 3. Bucket.
Nice shot.
Wheaton's first bucket of the game. Cuts the deficit in half. Vance to Glover, pushes it down the court, spins, goes up. Primer gets a hand on the ball, out of bounds off the Indians. Mitchell checks back in for Nelson. Lewis checks in for Davis. Reeves, baseline. Foul on Harper, his third. Reeves to go to the line. These Hornets, every time they've needed a shot, they've made it.
Well, they're staying aggressive. They're picking up some fouls, getting to the line, and getting good chances to score.
Won't go. Rebound Primer to Mitchell. Drake. Mitchell. Wheaton for 3, in and out, won't go, rebound Reeves. Under 3 to go now in the ball game. 3-point lead for the Hornets. Lewis gets the ball to Vance, but guarded by Mitchell. Down to Massey, he'll bring it out. Great patience by the Hornets. Lewis down to Massey,
nice
count it.
Great patience by the Hornets to open up their man Massey.
Well coached by McBroom as they are not going to take a foul.
Nice charge
shot without it going to Massey. There, Whedon's called with the charge.
Whedon just a little ahead of himself there. And a timeout on
out
the floor.
Kennett, 2:18 to go in the ballgame.
This game brought to you by A-Plus Medical Equipment in Dexter, your local provider for CPAP and BiPAP machines, home oxygen, and new diabetic shoes. Your locally owned medical supply company located behind Hickory Log in Dexter. Baker Implement Company in Malden, your local Case IH dealer. Also providing your everyday hardware essentials and new Case IH apparel. Stop by on Highway 25 south of Malden. Unico Bank in Kennett, serving all your banking needs. They support all of this year's athletes and wish the best of luck to all participants. Unico Bank, banking with people like you. Ag Explorer. Ag Explorer manufactures and markets nitrogen and phosphorus management aids, specialty fertilizers, adjuvants, and micronutrients that are proven to enhance farming applications. For higher yields and greater profits, visit agexplorer.com or see your local dealer for products like Enzone.
And we're back. A lot of purple in the crowd. A lot of it purple and white also. Holcomb and, Kennett trying for the four-peat. Kennett the bigger school. Holcomb the number six versus the number one seed. The crowd seems to be with the underdog. But he's got to help those tired legs. And there's Mitchell with the steal. Shot and a foul.
Yeah, Lewis picking up the foul there. And if he was, you gotta commit that foul hard. Keep Mitchell a chance at a three-point play. As tight as it is, you got to really make it hard on him. But he's got a nice chance to cut into this lead. Chance at a three-point play.
And connects. Two-point ball game now. And Mitchell with the steal. Lays it off the glass for a tie up. And we got a quick timeout, Holcomb Hornets. We'll be back in a minute.
We'll just keep it right here, Ed. Two straight turnovers by Holcomb, and Mitchell coming up with two steals in the backcourt. And, Holcomb's been able to hold off the defensive pressure by the Kennett Indians pretty good here in the fourth quarter, but here in the last two series, it's caught up with them, and Kennett tied this game.
Yeah, Mitchell steps up at midcourt. Now the purple, the fans in the crowd seem to think maybe there's a little too much contact there on that turnover, but either way about it, Mitchell with the steal converts, and now we have a tie ball game with a minute 59 to go in the game.
Holcomb will have the possession here with the tie game, but that still remains. Will they be able to handle the ball, get it across, and get into a half-court set? And they've really executed well in the past few series before those few turnovers, getting Massey the ball for good opportunities.
Nelson in the game for the Indians. Smith back in. There's another turnover off the infield, inbound. Mitchell tries to dump it down to Primer.
Mitchell should have just went up and shot that. He had a good look.
Yes.
He just thought Primer was right under the goal, but still good defense by the Kennett Indians.
I think Mitchell may have anticipated Massey coming out also, and Massey stood his ground underneath, but Primer. Down low to Massey, up, he's fouled.
Ooh. Almost picked up that basket there, but
I think the foul's going to be on Smith. We'll see. It is. So Collins' second foul. Massey is shoot two. Good.
Big shot by Massey.
Massey's been perfect from the line. Gives his team a one-point lead. Clark checks in for the Hornets. And a second. Great. Massey deep in the paint. Drake pull-up jumper. Won't go. No foul. Tipped out to Nelson. Gets it to Mitchell.
There's Mitchell looks.
He's going to be called for the wall because Massey offered that shot. Mitchell trying to say he let go of the ball and it was off Massey, but the referees did not see it that way. So turnover Kennett with a minute and a half to go in the ball game.
Coach McBroom,
timeout, 1:28 to go here in the ballgame. Holcomb's fourth timeout. They'll still have one remaining.
We'll be right back.
At Glenn St. and Kennett, we have a lot full of inventory and the best rebates of the year. I'm Danny Ford, owner of Glenn St. We just want the opportunity to talk to you about your next car or truck. For rebates are the best of the year, and interest rates the lowest to work with. It's a great time to buy, and our people are excited to help you make the right choice. We realize you have a lot of dealers to choose from, but I can assure you, no one appreciates your business like we do. Glenn Saint and Kennett, and God bless our troops.
Getting set to come back here. Holcomb with the possession, had to call it quick timeout so they wouldn't turn it over. But that's going to be Holcomb's game from here on out. Not turning the ball over, getting the ball up. And every time they've got it into the half-court set, they've got a good look, especially with Massey down low. So that's their intent, to get it across, not turn it over, and look for a half-court shot. Or shot in the half-court.
Out of bounds off Mitchell. Davis working against Drake. There's a steal by Nelson. Foul by Clark. Layup won't go.
Yeah, Hawkins got to really get some spacing. They had three guys there all together. And no really, you know, no real cohesion there in the offensive set. They were just kind of bungled up. So they're going to get some spacing to kind of free up these ball handlers.
Short. Weed checks in for the Indians. Lewis in for Clark. Can't get the second. Rebound Davis to Massey. Two-point ball game, 1 minute to go. There's a steal by Mitchell. He splits the defense, fouled, so he'll have to go earn them at the charity stripe.
Well, Holcomb, another few turnovers here. It seems as if they're just trying to hold on right now, trying to run as clock. There's 55 seconds left, but Kennett getting some steals here in late seconds.
And the roll. Well, it plays in their favor to run that clock out. They're not going to shoot the ball, I don't think, unless they get it in Massey's hands. Weed with the rebound. Can't control it. Placed up by Reeves. So I think they're going to want to get the ball in Massey's hands because he's automatic down low and almost automatic from the free throw line as well. But Reeves splits the defense.
Oh, no.
Rolls it in. Great shot by Reeves.
Crimer's going to take the three.
Crimer won't go. 30 seconds to go.
And a holding foul.
Not a jump ball.
What a shot by Reeves on the other end.
Foul's going to be on Nelson, his fourth. That'll put Davis on the line shooting two, and he can almost seal the game. Three-point lead right now. One of them makes it a two-possession game. Kennett thought it was a jump ball. They retained the possession arrow, but good.
Big shot there for Davis. He's hit some big free throws here in this fourth quarter. He's had his hands full tonight with Mitchell and all these other guards just hounding him all night long.
16 in the ballgame now for Davis. Eight this quarter. So he is getting it done at the end of the game for his Hornets. Oh, in and out. Smith the rebound. Kennett will push it. Drake Mitchell drives. He's fouled. That's going to be Vance's fifth.
Nice aggressiveness there by Mitchell. They're down four. Two possession game. Go to the hole. Either try to get that easy basket or pick up the foul. So good. Good effort on his part, and not a bad foul there by Vance. You don't want to give up an easy one for Mitchell to cut it to a two-point game.
Coach McBroom taking advantage of the unofficial timeout with the player substitution.
He's probably short on timeouts, so he's gonna make do with what he can get.
Absolutely. I'm tracking, he still has one, but I'm unofficial here. Mitchell, 10 in the quarter, 26 in the ball game. Good on both, they get 27. And they foul Clark. Clark will shoot two, or excuse me, Reeves will shoot two.
Holcomb just trying to hold on.
Nelson will take a seat as Smith checks in. Foul was on Drake, his third. Does not get the roll.
Kennett still in good opportunity here. If it's a miss, you know, Mitchell going the length of the court, or even Drake, they've got a good open court opportunity here. But Reeves really needs to hit this for the Hornets.
Won't go, rebound Whedon.
Oh,
Drake throws it away. With 10 seconds to go, great defense by the Hornets. Drake saw Mitchell open, but Mitchell cut across the lane.
I think Smith was, okay, we got a break. We'll be right back.
Excuse me, yeah.
These days, we are bombarded with insurance ads and websites. But can they really save you money? Trammell & Son Insurance represents over 70 years. Family-owned for four generations, all familiar with the particular needs of CMO farmers and offering convenience, low rates, and fast, friendly, local service. Call Trammell & Son Insurance for an insurance assessment. Whether it's farm, home, or commercial, we can tell you what's best for your situation so you won't be over or underinsured. Put our experience to work for you. Trammell and Son Insurance.
And Ed, go ahead.
Well, we're back, but it looked like, you know, Smith there. Drake saw Smith on the left side of the lane. Smith thought Drake was going to go for the shot. He was advancing across to position himself for the rebound. And Drake tried to dump it off to him, and as a result, there's nobody there for the pass. So both players thinking one play ahead. At the same time,
and this game's far from over here. 10 seconds left. Kennett's been able to get steals here in the backcourt off the press, so we'll see what happens.
They'll look to Massey. They'll foul Glover. Glover's been perfect from the line tonight. So the Hornets got to feel good about having Michael Glover on the line. Steady shot, count it. And this one to make it a two-possession game. Glover now 5 of 5 from the line this evening.
Big shot by
7.6 seconds.
This shot right here.
Even a miss and a rebound. It's going to make it off the top, and that just may have been the ball game right there.
That just might do it.
So Drake pulls up shot. Won't go. Rebound Holcomb. And the Holcomb Hornets have upset the Kennett Indians to win this 56th Christmas tournament. Congratulations to the Hornets. We're going to take a break and we'll be right back.
I'm a full-time wife and mom, and I also work as a substitute teacher. You can see why it seems impossible to get a college degree, but with Southeast Missouri State University's regional campuses, it really is within my reach. I can get a degree without leaving my hometown, and that's important when you have a family. Getting a college degree isn't easy, but Southeast makes it convenient.
See you, sir. And we're back. The Holcomb Hornets have won this year's Bloomfield Christmas Tournament as the sixth seed. And Ed, we talked about this about the week or two leading up to the tournament. The top seven teams could win this thing. And I wasn't kidding when I said that. You know, this tournament was very deep this year. It went 71 to Kennett all the way to 7 Portageville. Any one of those top seven teams could have pulled this off. And it indeed happened with the sixth seed Holcomb Hornets come away with this tournament championship.
You said it, and Tyler, you may have been the first to say it, but all throughout the gym all week long, everybody's saying the same thing. Seven deep, could go either way. Congratulations, Holcomb Hornets. Third year in the tournament. Excellent victory by their workhorse, Jamie Massey, the senior. Come up here and get this Christmas tournament victory in his senior year. It's just got to be something special.
And we're about to have the presentations here. Great tournament put on once again this year by the Bloomfield schools and staff, which they do a great job every year, which we'll talk more about here momentarily.
Sixth place, Bloomfield Wildcats.
And sixth place in this year's tournament, the Bloomfield Wildcats. I was impressed with the Wildcats in this tournament, Ed. They're smaller this year. They don't have the big guys like they've used to have here in the past few years, but a nice showing by the Wildcats this year. Fifth place, the Haytie Indians. And this is one team to look out for come district tournament time, Ed. The Haytie Indians are going to be very competitive in class two. Fourth place, the South Pemiscot Bulldogs. Probably the best turnaround team from last year. I think they may have been a 13 seed last year, come in as the fourth seed. They come away with fourth place this year. Third place, the Burning Mules. Certainly a tough team come down in class two play at the end of the year. Second place, Kennett Indians, looking for that fourth straight Christmas tournament title, but just ran up to a better Holcomb Hornet team tonight. Very good Kennett Indian team. They'll be back next year going for another title. Congratulations to them.
And the gym goes crazy. There's a lot of Holcomb Hornets here, but as we said also, I believe they are the underdog and the crowd favorite with that win.
Holcomb Hornets,
congratulations. Great tournament. They executed their game plan perfectly. Can't say enough. We talked about Michael Glover being the secret weapon for the Hornets because Jamie Massey's got to get his. But Massey, 30 points on the evening for the Hornets. 6 of 6 from the free throw line. Michael Glover, 14 points, also 6 of 6 from the free throw line. So the two seniors getting it done for them at the charity stripe, but also throughout the game. 16 points also for Chase Davis, the senior. 9 points to Ryan Reeves. 4 points to James Vance. So 75 points, 81% for the charity stripe. We've talked about it in several games this year that close games, the loser being very poor at the free throw line. Well, not the Holcomb Hornets tonight. Congratulations again. Can't say enough about this win for the Hornets. For the Kennett Indians, they were led by Cavante Mitchell, 28 points. 17 points to Antonio Breimer. 9 points for Akeem Nelson. 6 for Octavius Drake. 3 for Jay Edgerton. So all tournament team. First of all, Cavante Mitchell, Kennett.
Jamie Massey.
From Holcomb, Jamie Massey.
Excellent tournament, Massey. Probably your tournament MVP if they did hand him out.
Brian Patterson from Donovan. I'm not sure where he ended up, but he was close to 30 points a game. An outstanding tournament.
From Haytie, Marion Newbill.
And from Haytie, Marion Newbill.
He's one of the top guards in this tournament. It's been a pleasure to watch him play so far this year. He's potentially being an all-stater this year.
Seth Harris from South Pemiscot put together 14, 16, 17 points a game. Great tournament by the senior.
From Holcomb,
Ryan Reeves, the junior guard from Holcomb. Brett Rook from Bloomfield. Senior had another quality tournament under it for him this year.
From Kennett, Antonio Primer.
Antonio Primer from Kennett. Excellent tournament again. 17 points tonight for the senior.
From Twin Rivers, Michael Snyder.
Michael Snyder from Twin Rivers. They really rally around that. His senior guard does a great job rallying his team. Put on a fine performance in three games this year.
From Bernie, David Baker.
David Baker from Bernie. Had to sit out a game for an injured shoulder. Came back tonight, had an excellent game. So congratulations, David. Glad to see you back in the game tonight. From Kennett, Antavius Drake.
And from Hayti, Frankie Burton.
And from Hayti, Frankie Burton, Jr. Excellent tournament by Frankie Burton. Rebound after rebound after rebound.
Yeah, one of the best big guys in this tournament. He's a force to be reckoned with for the Hayti Indians.
Again, just can't say enough about the Holcomb Hornets and their game tonight. Kennett got down early, 8 points, fought back, had the lead, I believe, at the half by two, had the lead, or gave up the lead, was trailing by two, and Holcomb just wouldn't go away, made shots. When Kennett would go on a little run, looked to try to put the game away or out of reach, Holcomb come back, 3-4 points every time, and just stuck with it and stuck with it when they needed to be disciplined with the ball. And make sure the only guy taking the shot was their big guy, Jamie Massey. The Holcomb Hornets executed, make sure only Jamie Massey took the shot. And if he didn't make the shot, then he took care of it on the other end at the charity stripe, going perfect from the line tonight. So congratulations again, Holcomb Hornets. Exciting All-Douglas County final. But congratulations, Kennett Indians, for a fine tournament. I know they wanted to do that four-peat, but that that record of 7 straight from the Dexter Bearcats is now secured for at least another six years as the Holcomb Hornets are in the front place to usurp that title.
Yeah, we talked about all game whether Holcomb could be able to handle the pressure of, the Kennett guards and the Kennett applying the pressure. And Kennett forced some turnovers tonight. Holcomb turned it over probably 20-plus times tonight. They did a good job forcing the turnovers, but I think we didn't give enough credit to Holcomb's defense throughout the night. They really sealed off the paint and cut down on the easy opportunities for Kennett, because once you leave the lane open for Drake, Mitchell, and those guys to get into the paint, they'll eat you up all night. And they did a good job sealing off the paint. Massey, of course, it's easier to do with Massey right there guarding the paint. And, the other guys chipped in and sealed off that paint, and they rebounded when they needed to. So, Holcomb's defense was probably, a big factor in this game that we kind of overlooked. They did a good job.
Oh, absolutely. They stayed in that zone. And, of course, Jamie Massey's a big part of that. A lot of cleanup points Antonio Primer and the Kennett Indians get, they didn't deny because of Massey's presence. But he did a great job, just stayed in the paint, kept his arms straight up, stayed out of foul trouble, knowing that his Hornets needed him in the ball game. He wanted to be in the ball game, played the full game. And so, again, hats off to the Holcomb Hornets. Congratulations, Coach McBroom. Just an exciting all-around final.
Sure. Great tournament. We knew it was going to be the best that we've had in probably the past handful of years, and it certainly came out that way. Holcomb Hornets, the sixth seed, winning the tournament championship. I don't know, going back, who, what's the lowest seed that's won this thing, but, it's as a sixth seed winning it, that says a lot about the Holcomb Hornets, but it also says how deep this tournament was this year, because Holcomb was a sixth seed, but early on, they win a few more games early on in the season. They could have easily been a 2 or 3 seed coming into this thing.
Oh, absolutely, because and the couple of losses they came in with were in overtime or by two.
Hayti, Bernie.
To bigger schools, and so to quality program schools. So you know, maybe a little, not as much respect as they should have from the seeding at the seeding meeting, but at the same time, I don't think anybody's going to deny the Holcomb Hornets or overlook them the rest of the season.
I think the seedings, you know, they're at the bottom half of the bracket. You could say that Donovan should have been up more, and, you know, Saxon Luther may have been up a bit more, but, you know, the seedings were fairly accurate there for the top half, and it just goes to say how deep this tournament was this year. A great tournament beginning to end. Another great tournament put on by the Bloomfield schools. Dustin Hicks heading up this thing as tournament director this year. We've used to seeing Eric Bowles around, but you know, he's moved on from Bloomfield schools. But a great job that the Bloomfield schools do, and the people that you don't see out here on the court, back in the hospitality room and taking care of things back there, making sure everybody's got refreshments and all. They do a great job back there. I know Starla Pulley does a great job back there with all of her help back there with the hospitality room and everything that goes on here at the Bloomfield Tournament. They've been doing it for years, and they do it right, and they deserve the recognition of doing so.
You bet. So, thanks for watching and tuning in. A happy new year to everybody. Be safe while you're out and about celebrating tonight, especially all you guys down in Holcomb. Hopefully they were enjoying the game down at Strawberries. Half of Southeast Missouri is going to be eating dinner there tonight anyway.
Right.
So either way, but Tyler, you know, just thanks again for letting me be a part of the tournament. I always enjoy it and love being here. So a great crew you had working with you again this year.
Good night, everyone.